Hello everyone and welcome to midday.com. Today I have two of the hottest personalities with me, but I can assure you that they're one of the coolest judges on TV right now. Hi Sunny, hi Rannvijay.
Hi, how's it going?
Great. So you guys have been judging Splitsvilla for a long time. So how has been the journey over the years?
I would say hosting, because judging is not part of our... We don't judge.
We judge them not within at all. Ourselves.
Within inside. Every year that I meet Sunny on the set or before on the promo shoot or something, we're like so excited because both of us enjoy that process as spectators. Because we go there and we're like, okay, what's the thing for today? Okay, this, the theme, okay. And then we give it out. Like both of us do our job and then we see amazing things happen and we're always just looking at each other and just enjoying. If I wasn't on camera, you'd sit me and her. You'd see me and her sitting and be like, oh, no, interesting. Oh wow, sure. It's amazing. I look forward to it. You know, every year. Though it's in the worst condition because in the hottest time of the year.
Oh, they chose the one place in the entire planet this year that is record-breaking heat in the entire world.
Where was it?
They picked the one. It was in Jaipur this year. Oh, and man. We had no idea. I mean, we knew it was going to be hot, but it was really warm this
because
year.
The tasks and everything are mostly outdoors.
Everything is outdoors. Even this interaction, if we had to have with the contestants, it's outdoors. It's looking great.
Yeah, because it was at a beautiful palace.
Yeah.
Like a palace spa resort. Looks like a palace. It's beautiful. It's
Here's
gorgeous.
The kicker. The thing is, there are a lot of shows that are difficult. And this, you know, like a Survivor or something, you're like, oh my God, these people are going through so much. On Splitsvilla, you're like, wow, these guys must be enjoying themselves in this palace. But it, the color of my shirts, they change because all of it becomes darker because we're like, but anyways,
so
even after that, we have year after year, as soon as it's like this date from this date, it's the most exciting. It's a lot of fun.
What can we expect this time on Splitsvilla?
Crazy? Crazy is a good word. And laughter beyond laughter. I don't know what they're going to beep out, but I hope that they at least keep the beeps there so that you can guess what's being said based on reactions or based on half of whatever was said. Because the other parts of the beeps, I swear I learned so many different things this year. It's amazing. This I learned.
A lot of this. Excuse me.
Chal.
Yeah. So for Sunny, it's actually educating. It's like the system is giving back to her now.
I know. You know how many times now I end up saying some weird bad word.
Don't say it.
I won't say it. Don't worry. Don't worry, family.
The thing with Sunny is sometimes words are used by contestants in a very casual way. And she thinks it's a casual, cool word. And she says, oh, no.
Alas, like, what's the meaning of this?
Still a bad word. Yeah, so that's why, just check with me first.
What did you say?
No.
I didn't say anything. I didn't say anything.
Seekha hai. Seekha hai. Aadmi ko.
Aur itna seekha hai. Kya kare?
Hame bhi kuch batayin kya seekha hai.
You can imagine what is being said on reality shows where children are fighting.
By now we're getting Splitsvilla is in its 12th season and this season it's your best shot at love. Hamare season mein
itna pyar tha.
Bahut pyar tha, but also we are also adapting because the last time we fell in love we got married to those people and we've been out of the game for many years. Now it's totally changed. So we're also getting educated, like I said, in the new ways of finding love. And on the show, that's the whole thing ki aajkal ki generation, they are on apps, they swipe left, right, you know, more than the vibe that you get from a person physically, meeting someone in a place, is now it's a virtual place. So while we are doing these interactions with the guys, we're also like, oh, really? Like somebody would do that? So for us, it's a great discovery. And you know, people ask me that you're doing the same show. It's not the same show. It's a different show every year. And it's a different experience for us. So this year we did a lot of that, and these kids are so sharp, man. And what she said, na, that you know what all can be said on a reality show. These kids now, 12 years, if they're 19 today or 20 today, they were 8 when Splitsvilla started, right? So they have been watching Splitsvilla for, say, if they started watching in 13.
No,
14.
We can't say that they learned all those bad words on Splitsvilla.
No, not bad. It's the that these kids today who come on reality shows, they are not, their childhood is different from us because we never saw a reality show growing up. We never saw a reality show or something. These kids are already like, they're ready. They're so ready. Like, you don't have to tell them, okay, you know, listen, today we'll be doing this. And then if you're angry, just control. They're like ready,
fat,
like they could make the show.
Fattu.
Huh?
Fattu.
That's a word that she doesn't know what it means. She'll just say it.
Yeah. Everything is on social media and everything is like, you know, Tinder. Have you guys ever been on Tinder?
Nah.
Or any dating app?
Never. These dating apps were made after I met Priyanka. It was like a thing in the world. Oh, he's met her, he's going to get married. Let's get the apps out. I think it was a suggestion.
Would you have been on one if you all were not married?
If I was single, yes. Because you have to adapt as a human being. Whether I would have enjoyed it or not, I don't know. But as a, like, because every time there's a new app, we're on it, right? We try it, we are on Twitter, everything. So if as a single person, if there's a is the app, you'd probably be on it.
And what would your Tinder bio read if y'all were on?
Mine? I don't know, man.
It would say, don't bull beep me.
Yeah.
Because who wants that to happen?
See, I think it's different for...
Like, why lie?
It's about the age. Right now, at this age, I don't know what my profile would say. But if I was single at 25, 26 and there was Tinder, it would probably highlight my, what I thought would be my good points, but mama's boy. That's the no-no, right? Imagine you say, mama's boy. Swipe, whatever. What is the bad one?
Left.
Oh, see, got.
If they have that option there while you're signing up, mama's boy, there should also be a scale, yeah. 1 through 10. Yeah. How much are you a mama's boy? If it goes to 10, then you know, like, you've got to let that one go. If it's somewhere in the middle, then it's great.
No, but 10, he won't know himself. So it'd be like, call mom once a day, only eat mom's cooking. Yes. Like this, they should be like, trick the guy into the
iron my chaddis, fold them nicely, put them in the drawer. Does she pack my bag?
Oh no.
I think some of the guys won't even know that they are a mama's boy.
They won't know it. That's why you need a questionnaire like that. Like I went to a boarding school, right? So every time I don't know a single friend whose mom's packed their bag anywhere, like, would like, dude, that's, but guys, their moms pack their bags, now they don't know their mama's boys. So in a questionnaire like this, and that's part of exactly what we do on Splitsvilla this year, like trying to tell girls, find out about boys, boys find out about girls, and these are the kind of things that you find out. Whether it's good or bad is up to them. The choice is up to them. But at least you find out things about yourself.
Thank you, Sunny and Rannvijay. Thank you so much.
MTV Splitsvilla X2. Best shot at love.
Hi, I'm Sunny Leone and you're watching Midday.com.
Subscribe to Midday India. Get direct notifications on all our videos by clicking on the bell icon.